Now, we will learn second point from the module number 2 is resources required for flexible approach of learning. For this topic, I am going to provide you some e-resources and some learning material here. Please click on the link. In this link, you will find more information about flexible learning and other related content. Resources required for the flexible learning. In this diagram, you will see the various types of learning resources are mentioned. The resources are videos, internet resources, PowerPoint presentations, assistive technologies, podcast and mobile, and other diagram you can see PDF file, library material, ebooks, braille material, audio material and notes. In these resources, how to use in your daily teaching or while implementing flexible approach of learning. So when you plan your lesson, so you have to first decide the what type of resources required for your topic. So you can prepare in this format. You can select any resources as per the learner requirement, because you know better than other about your learner. So first one is that you can prepare some small videos about the small concepts and subtopics, or you can cover sub contents also. Or you have to prepare some videos as per your own, or you can download videos from internet resources, from other websites, or some you can give some examples from BYJUS material also. So you can show them some videos. Then from internet resources, you can download some ebooks, some PDF files and some website links and some clip arts, some cartoons, various resources used in your teaching process. Then PowerPoint presentation should be prepared on the content which topic you are going to explain in your classroom. Assistive technology, which is specially useful for the disabled children, visually impaired, hearing impaired and other disabled children, you can use the assistive technology for them. Then you can take ready-made podcast available on the net, you have to use, or otherwise you have prepared your own podcast. There is audio type material and mobile also. Actually, when we teach some specific concept, then we always say our student, do not use mobile, do not see mobile. But in this flexible approach of learning, you have to allow them to use mobile for the learning purpose only. You can give them proper guideline and how to find, how to search learning material from relevant websites. So in this way, you have to use these resources in flexible approach of learning. In the second group, ebooks, various types of ebooks are available on the net, library material. You can collect some library material, some books from library, and some content, related content required from the encyclopedia or some journals, whatever available in the library, the related content, you have to just collect and bring it in the classroom and you have to provide to your learners while teaching. And notes. Teacher can prepare their own notes about the concept clarification or about your explanation. Some audio material, some audio wise, some expert lectures, some resources, some resource persons. You can tape that video audio and you have to use tape recorder also. And then braille material, especially used for the visually impaired learner. So you have to use braille material for them to give the proper justice for the every learner sitting in the classrooms. These are various resources are available, or you can produce, you can develop, you can prepare for your flexible approach of learning. To learn more about assistive technology, what is meant by assistive technology, what type of assistive technology is available for the disabled children, here the references are given, ebook, some ebook material and some websites link. You have to just click on that link and refer this ebook, you will get the additional information about assistive technology.